One day, someone destroys your window with a football. You immediately run there to find out who that was. What you see is a group of kids running away. There is no chance you can say who has done it, and there is no CCTV, which means that you will need to pay for the damages yourself. Obviously, you are very unhappy, especially that you have a lot of different extraordinary expenses this month. Then, you meet one of your neighbors, and you share entire story with him. However, he has a slightly different approach to that. He says, well, maybe you need to spend money on the new window, but because of this our economy will grow. You need to hire somebody who will make a new window and install it for you. That person will spend money and boost the economy. Think how many people would lose jobs if windows were not destroyed. You're somewhat surprised with that logic, but it makes you feel better for a second. You go back to your flat and think again about the whole story and your neighbor's explanation. You realize that conclusion from the words of your colleague is that it is good for the economy if the windows or other things are getting broken, so there is a need to create more and people have jobs, etc. In other words, destroying is good for the economy. What? Wait, so if I burn my house, it will be good for the economy? That doesn't make any sense at all. The story of Broken Window is originally written by Frédéric Bastiat, the French political philosopher. Above story shows how some politicians, in this case your neighbor, think about the economy and job market. What is wrong with this thinking? Well, first of all, if your window is not broken, then you can spend money on something different. You can buy shoes, food, petrol, or just save money for later. Which basically means that you will create jobs anyway, but according to your desire, rather than necessity. Second thing is that wealth is about acquiring, not destroying. If your window is broken, it means that entire economy lost window and also lost something that you should buy if you wouldn't be forced to buy a new window. That is why we call this a broken window fallacy. On one hand, you see that new window will give work to certain people, but what you can't see is that it will not give the job to food makers or shoemakers, and that entire economy actually lost that particular window. That story has actually deeper implications than that. Look at the job market, especially at what public sector is doing. When government creates jobs in the public sector, it is actually draining money from the taxpayers. As a result, we can see that government built brand new shining workplaces for 1,000 people. But what we can't see is that because of taxation, businesses across the country needed to fire 1,000 people they can't afford anymore. What we have as an outcome? On the surface, the unemployment rate is the same, but if you look deeper, you will see that now fewer people contribute to the budget and the country's economy is actually poorer. I hope you enjoyed this animated video. Subscribe, share and comment. If you want to read Bastiat, I will leave the link to his book in the description. If you would like to see any particular topic summarized or reviewed, let me know in the comment section. Thanks guys and stay tuned for more!